Welcome back. We were discussing about the speech and conference coverage. So far we have discussed about the essential and the requirement and the preparation part to cover a news event. So we already have cross-checked about how to communicate the setting of the event to the readers. So now we are going to the second part, that is the content part of the speech. How to communicate about the content being discussed in a meeting or the conferences or the speeches. So let's see how it could be done. So when it comes to covering the setting, we know that we need to be a part of it and we have to get the details. So the better we can communicate our experiences to the audience. But when it comes to the content part, the notes must be accurate. So whatever being discussed or told in the meeting, that has to be noted down clearly so that the misinterpretation will be avoided. So we can give the exact detail which the speaker is being told on the stage. So the good speed of writing is another requirement here, because it always goes with the speed of the speaker. So better to practice writing with the speed to note down the important points, and ability to pick the right lead is another essential here. So a good lead always help you to attract your readers towards the story. So the ability to pick the right lead is another essential. And in a speech or report, there are few things which we cannot miss, just like the list of the dignitaries who has taken part, and if presented with the prepared speech, in case a speaker presents his written speech at the conference or at the meetings, you can collect that prepared or the printed speech, and that will be a reference point to you. Just see speaker add anything or leave something. In case you have the copy in your hand, you have to cross check again that is he speaking from the same print, or he is adding something, or he has missed something from the published or the written content. So that has to be cross checked. Make a lot of notes and pick interesting points later. So this is a key point a reporter need to observe and to follow, that note down every possible points so that you can pick a good lead later. So far we have checked regarding the setting and the content. Now we have to concentrate on the writing of the speech report. So when it comes to writing of the speech report, avoid using the quotes in the beginning for all the speech reporting, because it is a common tendency that we directly start with direct quotation lead. But that is not the mandatory part when it comes to speech reporting. You need not quote the quotation of the speaker every time in the lead of your speech report. You can follow other types of leads also. So here, plenty of quotes could be used elsewhere in the story. So we have to concentrate on this one too. And a speech report need to be balanced one. In case it is some conferences or debate kind of programs, there'll be multiple aspects discussed. We have to give space to each and every content equally so that our story will be the balanced one. If a speaker makes some outrageous accusation, you should make some attempt to check whether or not it is correct. It is not like we are directly writing down whatever he has mentioned. Definitely will be very safe to quote whatever the speaker has given in the speech, but still it will be better in case we cross check the content which he demonstrate at the time of speech, because it is always about the authentication issue. So better to cross check and to publish it later. And in case it is an opinion, you should try to get a reply from anyone who is attacked in the speech at the time of allegation. In case you put some allegation on someone, it is always better and safe that you take the reaction of the person who is being allegated later, so that you will be getting the balanced version here. It is also worth thinking about what the speaker did not say. Another key element which you need to observe. Let's check with one instance here. the finance minister was speaking on the eve of presenting his budget and did not mention economic matters, that would be newsworthy, because you know that finance minister has to give some mention regarding the economic matters of the nation. In case he missed that one, definitely we have to concentrate on that one too, why he hasn't given that statement, or why there is no mention about economic matters in the budget. Definitely it won't happen, but you can keep this instance to understand the consequences here. Next, make sure that your story contains at least a few of the points which I am going to mention now. Check on your screen. The first one is the names and titles of the speakers, and the major points of speech, plus necessary background details of the story. And this is essential in a speech reporting, and definitely the time, place and the purpose of the meeting, and plenty of strong quotes of the quotation of the speakers, and the size and composition of the audience, plus any important people who are the part of that particular conference or the meeting, and audience reaction if they are significant. Only in case they are significant you can concentrate on audience reaction as well. And next one is the follow-up. So most news stories do not end when the speeches finish, so we have to think about collecting follow-up details later. So even that could be a good story later. There may be some demands assured, you will have to check up later to see if they have been acted on. You know that in political rallies it happens. There'll be so many assurance given to the people, but a good reporter can always go with the follow-up story later, that whether they have fulfilled that assurances or not. And some events have effects long afterwards, and these may provide good follow-up stories for a speech report. So class, this is all about covering a speech or conference or meeting. Let's meet in another lecture later. Thank you.